Ankita, tell us about the tour you're about to take with Ginny from Hasbro. What's the mission of the tour and what are you going to be seeing?
The mission of the tour today will be to focus on the future of play. We'll be seeing how technology is changing the way we play, how much we play, and how esports and gaming is really going to change the way we talk to our consumers.
So Ginny, your mission as a marketer from Hasbro, the future of play, it's a huge topic. So
absolutely, really something we're very passionate about, clearly.
Really fun, and there's a lot going into it. So what are you really looking for in terms of innovation and platforms and technology that's going to really help you market your products to the consumers in 19 and beyond?
The framework that I use for evaluating technology for Hasbro really is how can it amplify and enhance what are our core strengths. And for me, there's two things that Hasbro does extremely well that we're focused on every day. One, we're driving proprietary consumer insights by listening and learning from our consumers about how their patterns aren't what they were even last year. And the second is, you know us as robust storytellers. Right? So we are really thinking about the characters and the stories, how to deliver that on different platforms, different devices, and can technology enhance that? Because as amazing as all the tech that I'm sure we're about to see, it's also a very cluttered space. And if that technology isn't grounded in consumer insights, I don't think we'll be talking about it next year.
So you're about to see some interesting esports and gaming platforms and displays. What sort of signals are you going to try, or teaching moments are you going to try to take from esports going forward?
So Hasbro is actually engaged in esports with two of our brands, Dungeons of Dragons and then Magic of Gathering, has a huge esport following. So we see 1 million monthly views of the game being streamed. And I think what we're learning about the platform and the culture is the power of the fan economy. And we think that in esports, I think the success comes because globally, people have really united in a very authentic way about these characters and games they love to share. So they're spending their time, their energy, and of course, now they're financially fueling the entire system. And I think that power of the fan translates beyond those brands. We've seen it apply to brands that have been around for decades, like a Transformers or Monopoly. So it's really thinking about how are we listening to our fans and making them the ambassadors of the experience. And I think that's some of the tools that we're excited to see more about how technology will enable that in new ways.
A lot of this we're talking about is delight and surprise. How are you using technology to delight and surprise your users and your customers?
I think we're doing it across the portfolio in different ways. So we have products and innovation in our gaming lines, for example, that capitalize on social trends and bring those to a physical form. So games that are fun to play, but more importantly, fun to watch other people play and fun to share as social currency. And we've seen that come to life in so many ways that, you know, started by watching YouTube videos and really seeing some of the challenges and thinking about how as Hasbro can we make that a true experience for the family and deliver those.
So Ankita, in your work on this project, did your notion of play change?
Definitely. And I think a good exhibitor that describes this is Icaros. So what Icaros is doing is they've combined fitness and play to build experiences. And I think it helps me understand how it's more and more important to connect your consumer with a very good experience.